So, hallo, zurück aus der Mittagspause hier auf der FrostCon und unserem Talk der Foskis. Hier mit einem Vortrag von meiner lieben Kollegin Astrid, die uns jetzt zunächst erstmal den Foskis-Verein und ihre Beziehungen zur OSGO und dem OSM und so weiter mal präsentieren wird. Ja, vielen Dank.
Ja, danke Anne für die Vorstellung. Ja, mein Name ist Astrid Emde und ich bin schon ganz lange in diesen Bezügen OSGO, Foskis, Phosphor G und OSM unterwegs und ich wollte den Vortrag auf Englisch machen. Also, I switched to English because this presentation should be in English, all the slides are in English and I would like to tell you about OSGO, Phosphor G, PhosGIS and OSM and would like to introduce you to these four projects and would like to encourage you to get to know the projects and to get involved. Okay. So my name is Astrid Emde. I'm from Germany here, from Cologne, and I work in Bonn. And I'm active in the PhosGIS EV, which is the OSGO local chapter. We will learn about OSGO soon. I'm an OSGO charter member since 2010, and I'm involved in a project which is called OSGO Live. We will get to know that soon as well. And I'm part of the MapBender team, which is MapBender is an OSGO project. And I work at Ware Group. We do a lot of open source software projects here in Bonn. First, I would like to introduce you OSGO, the open source geospatial foundation, which is a global foundation which is very active all over the world. And here you see the website of the OSGO. That's a new branding which will be rolled out soon, and people are working on this. And when we talk about OSGO, we have to look back in the past. This slide is referencing to 2004. Years ago, GIS software was there before, and in 2004 a new name was coined, and the name was Phosphor G. And at that time the name was standard for free, libre and open source software in geoinformatics, and it was used at a conference in Bangkok, which was a GIS GRASS user conference. At that time, you see some people are there at that meeting. I marked maybe Markus Netele, who is very active in the GRASS project at the moment still, and Jim Westerveld, who is an original GRASS developer. They were at this meeting, and also Venka, you see here in the middle, who is at the moment the president of OSGO. And already in 2004, this name Phosphor G was used. People discussed already about collaboration, about founding a foundation and coming together. And then 2 years later, in 2006, the OSGO Foundation, which stands for Open Source Geospatial Foundation, was formed. And you see some projects were involved. You can see here at the logos. And people had a meeting in Chicago where they formed this foundation. Now we would like to get to know more about the OSGO structure and what is going on in the name of OSGO. I said already that it is a global foundation. We have a board of directors which is voted every year. It has 9 directors and presidents. At the moment we have 2 presidents, we will see in a slide later. And we have charter members, you see here at the bottom. We have 312 charter members at the moment. They are voted every year. New members can come to OSGO. And these charter members are electing the board. And also we have committees. We have different committees like the marketing committee, OSGO Live committee, conference committees. You see here in the middle. We have projects, software projects, for example, and we have all around the world, all over the world, we have local chapters. They can be language chapters, like we have here in Germany. The FOSGS is representing Germany, Switzerland, and Austria, the German language-speaking areas. Or they can be chapters like OSGS Belgium, and they represent a country. And here you see the actual presidents. They are Venka and Elena. They are the presidents at the moment. And here, at the right, you see, at the left, sorry, you see Dirk, and Dirk was the president till last year. But on the photo, I had only the three, so I thought, okay, let's don't cut them in the middle. But here, see, you see the presidents. If we follow the, have a look at the membership. I have a slide from 2015. You can see how the charter members grew we have 312 charter members, and you see how they are spread all over the world. On this slide, you can see the OSGU projects. We have 23 OSGU projects at the moment, and we have 6 projects that are in the incubation project process. Because if you want to get an OSGU project, like you would like to add your software project to OSGU, it has to go through an incubation process, and you have to show that you have an active community, that your code is somewhere public, that you follow the rules and don't use closed software or closed code. And if you pass the incubation process, your project will join the OSGU project, and you can get all the advantages that this global association has. We have outreach projects, like the Geo for All project, which is promoting education and free access to software and free data all over the world. We will see it later. Or the OSGU Live project, we will see later too. And we have community projects like the MapProxy or PG Routing projects, which are software projects as well. We have many, many mailing lists. Every project can get a mailing list. And here you can see a statistics from FOSFG 2017. I get up-to-date information. So we have more than 30,000 subscribers to mailing lists already. We have global conferences. The main conference that is organized by OSGU is FOSFG conference. It takes place every year all over the world. And you see at the bottom the FOSFG Boston 2017 logo. FOSFG has been in Boston this week. So it just ended yesterday with an OSGU code sprint in Boston. And next conference will be in 373 days in Africa, in Dar es Salaam, in Tanzania. So you see, we have conferences all over the world, and at this FOSFG conference, people come from all over the world, discuss about FOSFG projects and software and data and development. You can visit workshops and go to presentations, you can go to code sprints and get to know people who maybe are interested in the same topics like you are. At FOSFG Boston, over 1,100 people came to that conference, and we are looking forward to next year Dar es Salaam conference. If you don't want to wait till Dar es Salaam, you can have a look in the OSGU Wiki. You see there are conferences going on all over the year. And if you check this website, you will see that there are many conferences taking place in the next months. We also have a project which is called Geo for All, which has a mission to make geospatial education and opportunities accessible to all. and it's a project where people come together and they work on educational material. They work on educational material which can be used at universities or at school or in workshops. And this project works close together with ICA, ISPR, UNGIS and other partners worldwide. As you can see here on the screenshot, we have over 120 labs all over the world. A lab is a place, maybe at your university, that you provide, where you have computers, where you have maybe workshop material, or where you have a person you can talk to and have the opportunity to get to know FOSS.js software and about OSGEO. We also have a project, we are also involved in Google Summer of Code. We are a mentor organization, so we apply every year with some projects for the Google Summer of Code. We do it since 2007, and this year in 2017 we have 15 students which were accepted, and they are working on different projects and are mentored by OSGEO people and do good jobs to bring forward the OSGEO software. So this is a really good opportunity for students to get involved and to get to know the software stack, the community, and maybe the companies where they can work afterwards. Then we have OSGEO Live, which is a great project. Here I have a screenshot of the OSGEO Live website. OSGEO Live is a project where every year, or till now every half a year, we provide Lubuntu distribution with pre-installed software. So more than 50 software projects are pre-installed, and also free data. So you can download OSGEO Live, run it in a virtual machine or on a USB stick, or as you like, and then you can try all the software without having the installation process. And the nice thing is that we have quick starts and overview documents, so for you it is easy to learn about the software and learn the first steps with the software. This OSGEO Live project is used in FOSS.G workshops and at our conference, FOSS.js conference, we use it always, and you could use it as maybe if you have a company with an academy, you could use it for your workshops as well. There's a question.
Does it have Mapnik in it?
Mapnik, yes, I think it has Mapnik too.
So you can have a map server running on it?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, you have map server, you have geo server, you have many.
For example, we can download OSM data and
yes,
put it on that. Right?
We have already OSM data as sample data, okay, on OSGEO Live, so you can start at once. We have it in a PostgreSQL database, okay, already. And
so it's already imported, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you can,
yes,
just check it out live. Oh, nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, and OSGEO and FOSS.G is all about community and family as well. So we have many events that build up community, like code sprints. Here you see actual photos from the FOSS.G code sprint in Boston, which took place yesterday. There's OSGEO people who were setting up the new website with a rebranding. And here at the button you can see the room where the people from the Boston Code Sprint met. Then we have an annual event in Bolsena. At the top you see photos from Bolsena Code Sprint. It's a really nice place in Italy, in a monastery where people from different projects meet every year. And we always also have projects that meet, like here at the bottom, the QGIS Hackfest in Pisa, and many, many more. There's another picture about code sprints. This was in Bonn last year at Phosphogy 2016. In Bonn, we had a big code sprint at Basecamp in Bonn, where people from all over the world came, and we met in a very nice place here in Bonn with caravans and nice atmosphere. But I have a warning for you as well. So if you get involved into OSGU or Phosphogy, you will hear a lot about cats. They are talking about cats in their presentations. So take care if you have. And you will get addicted, because these are like feedbacks from the last Phosphogy conference this week in Boston. So if you go there once or get involved, you always want to go to Phosphogy or always be part of the take part at the events. So it's great fun. And now we have a look at PhosJS, the German local chapter, the German language local chapter of OSGU. This is what PhosJS does, so community as well. And we have a closer look now. So PhosJS EV is an incorporate non-profit association. It supports PhosGIS, so free open source GIS software and free data. And as I said before, we are this local chapter for the German language community, which is called DACH. We are also the representation of the OSM community. We work together with the OSM community very tight. And many OSM people are involved in PhosGIS. We have more than 200 members. And let's have a look what we do. We organize an annual conference here as well. It's a PhosGIS conference. We organize booths at different events, like here FrostCon. We have Stammtisch, so it's called community meetings all over Germany, Switzerland, and Austria, and we have community meetings. So let's have a look at the conference, PhosGIS conference. It started in 2006 in Bonn with 350 participants, and on the map you can see where PhosGIS took place in the last years. It evolved from the map server Anwendertreffen in 2003 till 2005 it took place, and now since then it is the PhosGIS conference. In 2018 we will come to Bonn for the second time. We will come to Bonn and have PhosGIS conference here, and you are all invited to come to this conference. There will be about 400 to 500 people coming to PhosGIS. There will be talks about PhosGIS software, OpenStreetMap, free data, workshops, community meetings, BOFs, and it's really a nice event, and which is not very expensive, so it's quite affordable to go there, and it's worth going. So if you want to get more information about this conference, the website is already there. There will be a call for paper at the end of the year, and then hopefully we will meet in Bonn in March. If you want to know what PhosGIS is doing over the year, you can have a look at the wiki. Here you can see the last events that happened with PhosGIS. The next event will be InterGeo, where we'll be. We will have a booth there and a presentation area. And so we could meet at InterGeo, which will take place in Berlin in 2017. And here are some pictures from ARGIT as well. ARGIT is a conference in Salzburg that takes place every year, and we are there with PhosGIS and an OSGU day there every year too. So if you want to get involved, you can come to our booth here at FrostCon and become a member. You could have a look at our website and maybe go to the next Stammtisch, so the next community meeting, or join the mailing list and get involved. With FrostJS, we support applications. You can make an application for support. We have some money that we can spend over the year. So if you have a project that you would like to get supported, or you want to organize a code sprint or so, you can apply for support. We have this Förderanträge. You can get information from our wiki page, and then all the members of FrostJS discuss whether your application for support has value, and then you can get some money. And here you can see some events that we supported already. So hacking events, development, server costs can be supported. Here you have an example. Last year there was an OSM meeting. It's called Elbe Labe meeting. It will take this year as well. And it was supported by FrostJS EV and brought together the Czech Republic OSM mappers and the German mappers, and they collaborated together. FrostJS is also hacking events. Two or three times in a year, we go to Essen, to the Linux Hotel. It's nice that we are welcome there and we can make our hacking events there. With about 20 to 30 people, we can exchange, we can code, we have, a flight simulator here that you can try, and it's a great place to be and build up community. So the last thing I would like to talk about is OpenStreetMap, how you can get involved there. You can start mapping and build up the OpenStreetMap data without getting involved in the community. But if you want to get involved in OpenStreetMap and want to get to know which parts in OpenStreetMap need maybe people who get involved, the best thing is to watch this video. It's Peter Bart who is talking about OSM Ehrenamt. Sorry, I don't know the translation. So he's talking about different activities in OpenStreetMap where people can get involved. And it is a presentation from last FrostJS conference where he made this talk. This is all that I wanted to say about OpenStreetMap. You will find all the information at Peter's talk. And when we talk about recordings, I would like to mention the TEB AV portal, because it's a great portal where science and technology recordings are published. And we are happy that there are already many publications from FOSFG, from FOSGIS conference, from FOSGIS. All the recordings are published at the TEB. And it's not only that the videos are published there, they are analyzed. And the nice thing is that they are searchable. So you have can search for spoken and written words. So TEB will analyze the videos and collect words. And you could search for words in the videos or make a clear citation link. Or you have a clear citation link, or you can link to a special sequence in the video. So it's a really, really valuable portal where all the recordings are stored. And that's all I wanted to tell you about this organization. With the last slide, I would wish you that the FOSS will be with you. This is a painting that was made by the grandniece of Wenka that you saw before. And yes, I hope the FOSS will be with you. And I hope it was for you a valuable presentation to get to know more about the community. And I hope to see you at the next event.
Okay. Thank you for your introduction into the FOSGIS Association. Are here any questions first?
So
So if you go to your previous slides, especially where you have a list of projects.
Ah. Mm-hmm. This one?
Yeah. Is there MapNIC here or it's not there?
No, MapNIC is not incubated to OSGEO, but it's on OSGEO Live. So I said before that OSGEO Live is a collection of more than 50 projects, but not all open source projects concerning GIS are incubated in OSGEO. Okay. So MapNIC is not incubated.
And I think there are also other projects which are GIS related. Probably they are all in the
OSGEO
Live,
yeah.
But mm-hmm. not in this collection. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, not all of the projects that are on OSGEO Live are incubated, but and not all of the projects handling with GIS are on OSGEO Live.
Okay. Is there any reason why these only some projects are in here and some projects are out of this?
Every project can apply to be part of OSGEO, okay. And as I said, you have to pass this incubation process. Okay. So MapNIC project didn't incubate; they didn't ask to incubate yet.
So and a project if they are has to specifically apply, and if
yes.
they don't bother to apply, they are not here.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes. Okay. The initiative has to come from your project to get part of OSGEO. Okay.
But I was assuming that maybe it's just a collection of all the GIS projects. No.
No.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thanks.
But you can find most of them on the OSGEO Live mm-hmm. as well, even if they are not part of the OSGEO project directly. I have another hint that we have this code sprint next year on the Foscis again, maybe a little bit bigger than last year. And we want to make the last conference here in Bonn was the international conference Phosphor-G, but in Bonn, and the Foscis conference next year in Bonn is just the local one. But we want to make, I think...
Mm-hmm. It's not really fixed yet,
really
but
fixed.
We are discussing about making another OSGEO code sprint while Foscis conference is going on.
So even... Maybe you're not a German-speaking person. You can go there and take part in the hacking event because it was a really nice event last time. I hope we make
yeah.
it.
Yeah, I hope so too. mm-hmm. Okay, so thanks a lot.
Thank you.